All right, welcome back to another Sunday School Basics. Today we are going to end off the Old Testament with the Minor Prophets. Now remember, the Minor Prophets lived at the same time as some of the Major Prophets and had important roles, but had small roles in comparison in terms of the history of Israel. So let's begin. We have Hosea. Hosea is about God's love and being faithful to a people group, the Israelites, despite people being unloving and unfaithful. The authors consider Hosea. This happened around 722 to 721 BCE. It is allegorical, it is a narrative, it's poetry and prophecy. It was written in Hebrew to northern Israel. Now the next book we have is Joel. This one talks about restoration and blessing will be given to the people of Judah only if they repent or ask for forgiveness. The author is considered Joel. The timeline is around the seventh BCE, maybe as early as the 5th centuries. It is a book of prophecy written to the Hebrew people of Judah. Then you have Amos. This prophet calls for social justice as a clear representation of being a religious person. The author is considered Amos, written about 760 to 750 BCE. It is a book of prophecy written in Hebrew to the people of the northern kingdom. Then you have Obadiah, a book of prophecy and judgment over the Edomites, celebrating the defeat of Israel. This was a group who were happy and gloating over the fact that Israel got defeated. The author is considered Obadiah, and the timeline is 605 to 586 BCE. It is also a book of prophecy written in Hebrew to the people of Judah suffering at the hands of these Edomites. Then you have Jonah. You Sunday school kids who have grown up in this area know who Jonah is, Jonah and the whale. This book shows God's love for all people, even the people who are enemies of God, enemies of God and God's people. The author is considered Jonah, and the timeline is about 750 to 725 BCE. This is an allegory, it is a dialogue, it's a narrative written in Hebrew to the people of the northern kingdom. Then you have Malachi. This book is a combination of judgment but deliverance for Israel. The author is considered Malachi. The timeline is about 7 to 650 BCE. It is a prophetic book and written in Hebrew to the people of Israel and Judah. Then you have Nahum. Nahum predicts the Lord's judgment on Nineveh for its oppression, its cruelty, its idolatry, and its wickedness. The author is considered Amos. The timeline is about 612 BCE. It's a prophetic book, and it is written in Hebrew to the people of Judah. Then you have Habakkuk. This book shows a conversation with God about the destructive and the oppression of the Jewish people and why, and questioning why God hasn't responded yet. The author is Habakkuk, and the timeline is about 605 BCE. It is poetic, but it's written in prophecy in Hebrew to Judah, who is struggling to comprehend the ways of God. Then you have Haggai. This book calls on the complacent people of Judah to finish rebuilding the temple. The author is Haggai, and the time is about 520 BCE. It's prophetic, written in Hebrew to the Jews living in Judah. Then you have Zechariah. This book also corrects and encourages the discouraged exiles returning from Babylon to finish the temple. The author is considered Zechariah, and the time is about 720 to 480 BCE. It's prophetic, written in Hebrew, to the people living in Judah. Then you have Malachi. The book tells of the Messiah King who will not only judge the people, but bless and restore them. This referring to Jesus. The author is considered Malachi. It's written about 430 BCE and is written in Hebrew to the people living in Judah. Well, there you go. I'm glad you stuck with us. And that concludes the Bible basics on the minor prophets and concluding the Old Testament. So I hope this gives you a good snapshot, almost a trailer teaser, if you will. But I encourage you, go and read some of these stories and learn about the character of God and His sovereignty over all mankind, and you'll see His fingerprint throughout human history. Join us again when we're going to start tackling the New Testament. We'll see you soon.